Was 13 Reasons Why inspired by the Spanish series Elite? And why did it take 2 years to cut out the most controversial scene from the show? And what role did puppies and tattoos play for the cast? Welcome to Awesome Movies. I'm Dylan. Let's dive in. Beware of spoilers for 13 Reasons Why and Elite. Differences from the book. The show 13 Reasons Why is based on the 2007 novel of the same name by Jay Asher. Though the main plot lines were kept, the series changed a few things to enhance the effect of the story, as well as to turn the small book of less than 300 pages into a full 13-hour series. First, they expanded the storyline with some new characters to flesh out Hannah's journey. For example, one of Courtney's best friends, Stephanie, a typical mean girl, had one of the shortest descriptions in the script, quote, "pretty, comma, dumb." So the actress behind this character, Hannah Payne, had no references from the book, and therefore more acting freedom. But if you thought that the whole cast read the original book to get into their characters, you're wrong. Catherine Langford, who played Hannah Baker, was among those few who actually read it before the production of the show began. But neither her nor Dylan Minnette, who portrayed Clay Jensen, were familiar with the original story before the audition. Both actors said they deliberately did not look into it to avoid unnecessary pressure. Another difference between the book and the series concerned Dylan Minnette's character. In the book, Clay listens to all of Hannah's tapes in one night. The show expands that process to about 2 weeks to give more insight into Clay's life and emotions, as well as to tell the stories of the other characters. And as for the original tragedy, in the book, Hannah Baker ends her life with a drug overdose, but this moment is only mentioned fleetingly. However, in the series, the character's death is portrayed with explicit details. Well, at least that was the case until July 2019. The removal of the controversial scene. When the creators of 13 Reasons Why worked on the show, above all, they wanted to avoid glamorizing and romanticizing suicide. Yes, they did it in a brutally honest manner, showing the ugly and painful consequences of depression and assault. What was previously shown only in criminal news reports reached the cozy entertainment screens, and it sparked a lot of criticism. The most traumatizing scene was obviously the one where Hannah Baker takes her own life in her bath in season 1. The reason they included such a horrifying moment was to dissuade viewers from copying it. In a statement, Netflix said, "We've heard from many young people that 13 Reasons Why encouraged them to start conversations about difficult issues like depression and suicide and get help, often for the first time." Although Netflix added the warning cards to the beginning of the episodes and developed the educational website 13reasonswhy.info for suicide prevention, it wasn't enough. Many experts blamed the show for giving guidelines that could lead to a potential suicide contagion effect among teenage viewers. After consulting with medical experts, Netflix eventually removed the graphic moment from the episode, 2 years after it premiered. The current version glues the moments of Hannah looking in the mirror and her parents' reaction to finding her body. "We've been mindful about the ongoing debate around the show. We believe this edit will help the show do the most good for the most people while mitigating any risk for especially vulnerable young viewers," read the statement. The soundtrack symbolism. The show creators carefully picked every detail to ensure 13 Reasons Why emphasized one message, and the music choice was not random either. The show's fans quickly realized that some of the soundtracks and music-related details were kind of Easter eggs for the most attentive in the audience. Yes, the first episode of season 1 ends with the Joy Division song, "Love Will Tear Us Apart." Also, there was a Joy Division poster on Alex's bedroom wall. And when Clay walks away from Hannah in the hallway, we hear a cover of the band song, "Atmosphere." In case you didn't know, the singer of Joy Division, Ian Curtis, committed suicide in 1980. Those repetitive references were a clear emphasis of the main plotline. The first episode of season 2 ends with the song, "Love Vigilantes" by New Order. This band consisted of the remaining band members of Joy Division, who reinvented themselves with Bernard Sumner as a vocalist. This soundtrack possibly symbolizes a new chapter in the story that follows Hannah Baker's death, by kind of reflecting the past of these two bands. Dylan Minnette, who plays Clay Jensen and is also a musician, helped to pick the songs from the show to create the appropriate vibe. The music of Billie Eilish was featured in the show too, and Billie is a known anti-bullying advocate. Perhaps you also noticed some of Selena Gomez's songs in the series. Together with her mother, Mandy Teefy, Selena was one of the executive producers of the show. And a few years before that, she wanted to portray Hannah Baker, but later realized that her fame could put a wrong focus on the series. It was a special project for Selena, who had her own experience of being bullied. The singer and actress had to check into rehab to focus on her mental health, and even took breaks from social media to avoid toxic comments. Was season 3 inspired by the Elite series? While 13 Reasons Why definitely started an important conversation about teenage struggles, it was not the only series to take on these issues. Riverdale is shedding light on similar topics, but some fans spotted striking parallels with another Netflix original show, Elite. Yes, 13 Reasons Why changed its direction every season, from somber teen drama to legal drama and to murder mystery. And it's this latest shift in season 3 that kind of repeats the Elite plot. After a peer's murder, the students' lives change forever. New characters arrive, and they may or may not be involved in a cover-up. Of course, Elite did not invent such a plot, but in season 1, the events take place in two simultaneous timelines. The current lives of newcomers are explored along with flashbacks to the murder of Marina Nunear Osuna. Every episode gives some clues hinting that the killer is one of her friends, though the real culprit is only revealed in the season finale. Doesn't it look like the framework for 13 Reasons Why Season 3? Annie Ochola joins the school community and looks back at the horrifying events from the future. With all the show's differences, the Spanish hit arrived right in between Seasons 2 and 3 of 13 Reasons Why. And by that time, there was no teaser of what would come after the courtroom storyline. Do you think that Elite was an inspiration, or is it just a coincidence of catching relevant teen plotlines? Tell us in the comments. Support on the set. If some of the scenes from the show were hard for you to watch, just imagine how difficult it was for the cast to film them. The series plot does not include much fun, and it requires the actors to go into a dark place and get their negative emotions out. The whole cast often cried after the table reads when they saw all their parts coming together into a powerful story. Yes, even at the table, the actors were pushed to the limits of their emotional spectrum, and tears came as a natural reaction to that. And each of these breakdowns was followed by a traditional huge hug in the middle of the room. Thus, the actors made themselves feel better and coped with all the pressure from their roles. But the hugging out was not the only support tool on the set. The crew hired mental health consultants to advise producers, writers, and actors on the best way of putting the story together. The show's heavy material was translated for the cast in terms of feelings and credible reactions to a traumatizing experience. The therapists helped them navigate the journeys to their darkest places and come back to reality undamaged. But the cutest and most efficient mental support was provided by therapy puppies. Dogs are often used to relieve anxiety and provide a sense of comfort. And since most people love petting and hugging animals, this activity lifts their spirits and helps them stay positive. Dylan Minette said that there was a puppy per hour, and that helped a lot, especially in between emotionally exhausting scenes. Still, some actors found additional ways to shrug off the stress. Catherine Langford shared that she watched The Office a lot and played the piano, while others were goofing around and using the green screen for fun. Intentional timeline gaps. As we already mentioned, the show was meant not just to show the difficulties of teenage life, but also to prevent tragic outcomes in reality. And the creators reflected that intention even in small details that not many viewers noticed. This one takes us back to the end of season 1, when some of the characters were interviewed for Hannah's trial. Their testimonies were recorded, and we can see the date on the screen. The interviews were filmed on November 10, 2017, while the show premiered in March 2017. The small detail brings us a big message. There is time to change the situation. There is time to ask for help. There is time to make a difference and help someone out of their darkest place. Powerful, isn't it? What's with all those tattoos? Did you notice that most of the high school characters have tattoos? Yes, Justin, Sky, Tony, Alex, Bryce, and Monty are marked with ink, and it takes some additional expertise to determine whether those tattoos are real or not. But the question is, why do these underage kids have tattoos? Is that even legal? They may be seen as a means to reflect the characters' difficult life stories, some of which were not covered by the plot. But in addition to getting parents' approval for ink, the students must have had money to afford it. And not everyone out there has a job and supportive parents. Anyways, while on-screen tattoos remain kind of a mystery to us, there was another offset ink moment that is worth sharing. When the series premiered on Netflix, the cast and crew wanted to mark the occasion and to create a visible memory about the show that changed their lives. Thus, Selena Gomez, alongside actors Brandon Flynn, Alicia Beau, and Tommy Dorfman got matching tattoos on their wrists. They picked the semicolon, a popular symbol of people battling depression. This symbol will forever remind them whatever your struggle is, it's never the end. There's always hope to carry on. Who are your most and least favorite characters on the show? Did you notice any other interesting details? Tell us in the comments and subscribe to our channel. And please, stay safe and stay awesome!